Today we've got some exciting news from Midjourney. They've just dropped the alpha version of their V6 model, and trust me, it's a game changer. So grab your hot coffee, subscribe, and let's get into it. To enable it, we follow the same process as always by selecting the new mode from the settings drop-down menu or by typing V6. So what's new? According to their official announcement from David H. on their Discord server, much more accurate prompt following, as well as longer prompts. If you guys are using DALL-E 3, you can probably tell that writing a long prompt will yield even better results than Midjourney. We'll test all the features and compare them with the past version. Next, they mention improved coherence and model knowledge. So basically, it will be smarter, if we can call it like that. Then, we have improved image prompting and remix, suggesting that we'll be able to modify even more precisely. Just to make it clear, this is an alpha version, so we'll have to wait for the final release to see the full potential. Moving down, they refer to the capability of the V6 model to include text in the images it generates. Users can essentially create images that contain specific text with better results now. I've been waiting for improvements on this one for a long time now, and we'll test it out in this video. They are also introducing improved upscalers with subtle and creative modes, increasing the resolution 2 times. At first, there will be some features available like the dimension aspects. However, if you want to describe an image, we will have to use V5. So what is the difference and why do they say I have to relearn how to prompt? They basically say each word will have more impact than before. So for people who always use ultra, super, mega, and super realistic, you guys will have troubles. They also suggest that if you desire results that are closer to a realistic photograph, less influenced by subjective opinions or artistic interpretations, and more aligned with a literal representation, you should likely apply the default setting, Style Raw. They also refer to Stylize. Essentially, playing with this parameter allows users to balance between prompt comprehension and the visual appeal of the generated images. An interesting fact is, V6 is slower and more expensive than V5, and it has been in development for 9 months. So let's test it out. I'm going to start with a simple prompt, and let's see the difference. On the left side, we have version 5, and next to it, the new version. I wanted to test the level of detail in each version, but for some reason, I cannot notice the difference. Let's test with a similar level of complexity, but with another topic. Actually, I think V5 looks better in this case. Or maybe it is just my prompt. Let's test something I have seen a lot in social media. I am going to test prompts with text in the image. The prompt, let's say, a billboard with text subscribe next to the beach at sunset with a horizontal dimension. Take a look at this. In my opinion, this is a step forward. What about expressions or colors? We will probably see more hands with 6 fingers or deformed cars in different scenes. But personally, I have noticed improvements like multiple characters in a single scene. I mean, we could do it before, but now it makes more sense. Also, when it comes to photorealism, it has always been somewhat realistic, but now the details are just insane. Huge shout out to the Midjourney team. You guys are making great decisions. Just like it is subscribing to this channel because I will bring more in-depth tests of the upcoming features and improvements. Thank you for watching, and subscribe if you haven't already.